Learn how to securely send Azure Blob Storage data with Azure Data Share in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Securely sharing data has traditionally required you to use an external service like OneDrive and is difficult. There's a better way. We can use the Azure Data Share service to share data. So let's create one. Search for Data Share and there it is. Okay, and create one. All right, now I need to give this data share account a name and select a resource group like this, and I'll select a location. Okay, create, and I'll skip to when this is done. Here we go. This is the Azure Data Share account. From here, I can start sharing data. I do that by creating a new share with this wizard. First, I need to enter a name and a description and terms of use. These are the things that the recipient of the data will see so that she knows what it is. Done. All right, let's add data to share. I can choose from several storage options, including Azure Data Lake and Azure Blob Storage. I'll choose Azure Blob Storage. And here, I select this storage account and this container to share. Okay, add the dataset. And there it is. Let's continue. Now I can add one or more recipients that will receive the data by providing their email addresses. Okay. And here I can select to keep the shared data updated on a recurring schedule. That's a nice feature. Continue. And okay, that looks good. And create it. The share will now be created and the data will be shared. Let's receive the data. People that receive the data need to have a place to put the data, in this case an Azure storage account, which needs to have access rights to receive the data. Let's set those. I need to add a new role assignment. That needs to be the account that receives the data as owner, so that data share can write data in it. All right, done. I have received an email that asks me to accept an invite to receive data. When I click on that, this screen opens. Here is the data share. I need to accept it, so click here. And now, select a resource group. And for this demo, I'll use the same data share account. Receivers of data also use Azure Data Share to receive the data. Alright, accept and configure. Now I need to configure where to receive the data. I'll select a resource group and the storage account that we've configured access to. And I'll put in the container name that I'll use. Okay, and I also want to keep the data updated with snapshots and save it. Alright, so this is the share that I received and configured. Let's open it. Here it is. Here we can see that the snapshot hasn't run yet, which means that we haven't received any data yet. I can force it by triggering the snapshot like this. Alright, this can take a while. And when it is done, I have all the shared data in my blob container, as we see here. Azure Data Share is an easy way to securely share data that is stored in Azure. And it also provides a way to keep the shared data updated with snapshots. Go and check it out.